Welcome back, my artistic friends. As some optional art, I thought it would be perfect if we made some origami, because all you need is a single square piece of paper. No extra tools, no pencils, no scissors, nothing. So here is my example of what we're making, our crane. It's a very traditional thing to make in origami. Showing all those awesome angles. It is slightly complicated, but very rewarding to make, so I thought we would start our origami adventure with making this crane, just so you guys can feel really amazing about yourself, because I felt so proud. I've literally never made one of these before until I was practicing for this video, and I feel like an origami rock star right now. So here it is. Here's my crane. Yay! Sorry. So I'm just going to set him aside and talk about what paper we can use for origami. This red paper right here, I actually was fortunate enough to find a stack of origami paper in my basement, a whole bunch of random art supplies that I have not touched in quite some time, but I found it and I thought I would use this paper for our demonstration on how to actually do it, because it has two different colors on each side, and it's a little bit easier to follow along, I think, with the folds when you can see that the back paper, the front paper. It's a little bit harder to see if you're using computer paper, but this is more likely computer paper, notebook paper, what you guys are more likely to have at home. So I want to talk a little bit about how to make this into square paper. Don't worry about the size difference. All you need to worry about is that this is a rectangle, this is a square. How do we make this into our square? Everybody, I showed you guys how to do this, what was it, right before winter break when we were making our snowflakes. So you may remember, but I think it always helps to have a refresher, because it's not the most self-explanatory. Once you get it down a few times, it becomes second nature. But what I'm going to do, we've got all four corners of this paper. I'm going to start with this guy. Does not matter. You can pick whatever corner you're most comfortable with. I like this guy right here. And I'm going to take him and I'm going to bring him up to the top of this. What I really want to focus on is this corner right here. I want to make sure that that is a nice sharp edge of a triangle, and I want to make sure that the edge of this flap is right there in line with the edge of that flap. So sharp triangle right over here, nice point, and flat edge right up there, and then you're just going to flatten that out. So what does that give us? That gives us a triangle with this extra rectangle shape over here. All we need to do is get rid of this extra rectangle shape, and these two triangles will form a pretty perfect square down there. So let's get rid of this triangle. You may think, Miss Silvana, let me go get my scissors. You don't need them. Let me show you. All you're going to do is hold that rectangle down right on top of where the edge of this main triangle is. And that can be a little bit hard to do if you're folding it this way. It might be easier to do for you to hold it up and fold it backwards and make sure that that edge is indeed flat. You might want to do that until you see that it is flat. But either way, you will fold that triangle or that rectangle. And now we've got this folded. I'm folding it this way, and then I'm flipping it over, I'm folding it this way. And we're actually just gonna tear this right off. We want to make this seam that we just folded nice and weak, which thankfully is not that hard to do because it's just computer paper. It's not the strongest thing in the world. So what I do is I'm working on a nice hard flat surface. I'm going to take the edge of my fingernail, which is gross, and I've been doing so much yard work, so just bear with me, and I wish I had more nail because that becomes easier, but I'm just going to press my fingernail right along the edge of that fold and scrape and push that paper edge into the table. I'm going to fold that back again and do the exact same thing. Fingernail edge right into the side of the paper. If you don't have a super flat surface, you can always just take both of your nails and go right along the fold like that. And just do that enough times until it starts to feel really weak when you're folding it. And, I don't know, maybe two or three is enough, depending on how sharp you are with your crease. And then you are going to just start tearing off that paper. So what I like to do is I hold this corner nice and tight, and then I start pulling away from the other corner, and then I just hold it down flat. And you will see it starts to just tear, easy peasy, right along that line. Voila, get rid of it. Don't make a mess though. You should probably clean that up. I'll do it later. Open it up and voila, we have a square, which you can make into your awesome crane dude. I am going to set this aside though, because I really think this paper will be easier for us to see the differences. So now actually getting to making our crane. Sorry that that took so long. I'm going to take off the picture in picture now, so you can just focus on what I'm doing right here. See you on the other side. Okay, here we are. Here is our paper. We are going to take it from a square position into a diamond. Diamonds are way better than squares anyway, so we are going to take the top corner of our diamond. Paper seems to not want to cooperate. I'm going to take this corner up here and we're going to match it down right over here and make a fold. So some hints for doing origami is you always want to make these creases nice and crisp. So I always like to just run across them real quick with my fingernail, and then I'm going to open that back up. And then I'm going to pivot my diamond. So this line is up here. And I'm going to still take the top corner down to my bottom corner. Make that a nice point. It helps in my mind for origami if you are moving nice and slow. No need to rush it. You really want a good result anyway. And there are so many folds and so many sets in between the beginning and the end that you might as well take your time and really concentrate on what you're doing to make sure you have the best result possible. So now that we have our diamond with a T right down the center, what we are going to do is fold here. So let's actually turn this into a square, and we're going to take this top edge and match it up down here. We're actually going to make a crease that goes right in the middle of that X that's on our paper. And make sure these corners are nice and lined up. And fold. Fold. And crease. Open back up. Swing it around. And one more time. Top of the edge, down to the bottom of the edge. Flatten out that crease. Fingernail and open up. So now we have a square paper with an X running from each corner and a T running from the center of each paper. So that is 100% awesome. This is one of the trickier parts of this project, making a crane. So here's my inside, here's the back side of my paper. I'm going to fold this guy over just a little bit and hold him down here on the sides. You guys can see the red is on the inside, just like that. And I am actually going to try hold right here and push that edge out. And I know I can do it, I've done it before, and there we go. So we are actually just holding it and pushing right here, keeping these creases nice and tight, and you will get a shape like this. It is nice and just diamond all around diamond, right? So when I first made this, I want you guys to see the mistake I made that I thought, they're just not giving me the right directions. What did I do? I made it so everything was flat. I think I folded it in like this, yes. So instead of folding those up, I folded it in like this. This is a big no-no because we do not want everything flat on the bottom. See how it looks awesome still from the top, but look at the edge right here. No, we do not want that. Although it looks like a tasty wonton, that's not going to help us get a crane. So back to the step. We've got our X, we've got our T. You're going to fold that over. Hold on to the edges down here by those creases. And I think it kind of helps you use your pinkies. Push those sides out a little bit. And push together. Creases are staying. Push in right along those lines and see diamond not flat down there. And see what it looks like from all of those angles. Awesome. Okay. Now what you want to do, because we do still want to keep working on a flat surface and this is more three-dimensional, you're going to just collapse this side on top of this side. We have a diamond on this side, diamond on the back, and then these are just folded on the sides. So I'm going to set him down. We have a very complicated step done. Yay, you're amazing. Now, just more simple folding. We are going to take the corner of this diamond. You can still see the other ones flat on the table. We're going to take that corner, and we are going to fold it right in to that center crease that we can see. And I'm still going to use my fingernails because we still want nice crisp folds. And then we're going to do the same thing on the other side. Take this corner back in here, match it up right there, and fingernail. Make that nice and crisp. Now, you are going to fold this entire top down. Your opening is down here. That's the inside of your paper. This you cannot open. You're going to fold the part you cannot open right down on top of where you just folded. So you're actually making a crease right at the top of this line right here. And you've got that. You're going to open it up. Bring these guys out. And now you are going to open him just like this. It's like a cobra with the red on the inside. You're going to bring that up and flatten it. One more time, it looks like this. Fold those in, fold him down, open it back up. Take your bottom open corner. Fold it down here and pull up and flatten. You are now an origami master. You are going to flip that over and do the exact same steps to this diamond. So what did we do? We started with this corner and we folded it to the center of our fold right there. Crease, crease. Fold in, crease, crease, fold this guy down, and then open this up, fold this down at the center, bring this up, and flatten. That's amazing. Okay, so we should have something that looks like this. There's the inside, and then it looks like this on the sides. And you'll see there's a little opening there. And it looks like this. Front and back look the same now because we are masters. All right. From here, we are going to fold this corner just like we did the last time when it was a diamond. We've got a skinnier diamond now. We're going to take the corner of that diamond. You still see, we still have the other one back there. And we are going to again fold that to the center. Careful about the pointy parts down here. You still want those nice and sharp edges. Pull that to the center. And then you're going to do the same thing to the other side. Make sure you're moving nice and slow. Line those up. And get that crease over here. Fingernail. You're good. Now you're going to flip it over. And do the same thing again. We've already done it once, so you know you got this. Boom, fold that in towards the crease. Fingernail, make that sharper. Fold this one in towards the crease. And make that sharper. You have something that looks like this, without opening on the inside. Both sides look the same. You are doing awesome. So, now that you have that done, these are actually going to be your wings up here. This stuff will magically turn into your crane's head and your crane's tail. So what you're going to do is take your wing, and you're going to start to see there's a little triangle in there. You are going to take your wing down as far as it will go and crease. And you do the same thing on the other side. Take your wing as far down as it will go. Don't rip the paper. No need to push it. Just as far as it will go. And then crease. Now we have our wings. So, now that we have that, let's get to work on our actual crane's head. So, we have this area. Got our wings right here that we just folded down. And then on the inside, if you pull on those wings, you've got this big long diamond over here. Wings over to the right and left. We are going to use that. This place right here. We are going to take this big long guy and we are going to fold him right up as far as he will go. And this is our head, so we're going to fold the tip of this down and make it actually a head. See? Okay. Now, you are going to flip this guy over, back to our wings. We're going to actually work from the very back of our bird. So we are going to open that up, pull on your wings a little bit, take this tab and bring that all the way up. That is our crane's tail. We are almost done, guys. We got this. Okay. Now we've got crane's head, crane's tail. Wings are still stuck down here, so all we have to do for that is fold a little bit back, fold that a little bit to the front, bring those wings up. On them a little bit, and you have a wonderful, amazing origami crane. Look at that. Let me get myself back in there. You guys did it! Oh my gosh, I'm so proud of you! We've got a crane, and now my other crane has a friend, a little blue friend. Isn't that awesome? So, I hope that was pretty self-explanatory. I tried to go pretty slow. That might have been aggravating for you guys, but I always think it's better to go slow and anticipate what may have gone wrong than to rush through it. But here, I'm just so,
amazed that I was even able to make this. So I'm so happy. I can't wait to see if you guys do successfully make the crane. Send me a photo. If you can't make it, let me know how terrible my directions were. I will not be offended. I am so proud of you guys. Bye. See ya.